Hi there, welcome to this video. Let's see how to use Premiere Elements 13 in a very short time. Leave comments to improve our videos. Premiere Elements is a video editing software that follows Adobe Premiere Pro, but it is more small and compact and does not require a Creative Cloud subscription. When you open the software, a dialog box appears. You can choose here between Organizer, that opens Adobe Organizer, and Video Editor, which is Premiere Elements 13 itself. If you want to know more about the Adobe Organizer, watch the related video in this guide. When you click on Video Editor, choose Existing Project to open one, or New Project to start from scratch. The workspace is divided in four main sections that you can choose on top. The eLive tab is totally new and presents some new features and tips Adobe offers you. Quick, Guided and Expert are three different workspaces to create your project. Quick and Guided work together. Quick lets you create a video project using storyboards, and through Guided, you can add adjustments, effects, and transitions with tutorials and tips. We are going to see the Expert workspace directly, since this is the one where you can use all the features of this software. On top, you have some buttons to add, share files, and add adjustments and effects. On the center, you have a very big preview of your project and the timeline, where you will work on all. At the very bottom, other quick buttons we will see later. To add files, just drag them onto one of the rows of the timeline. Each row is called the track. There are two main tracks on the timeline: the video tracks that accept pictures and video frames, and audio tracks that accept just audio files and video sounds. Don't mind about the other tracks below. You can rename, delete, or add other tracks right-clicking on the left. Use the left white arrow to reduce or expand each track. If you want, you can also use Add Media in the top left corner to add files. All files added are collected inside the project assets. All files imported in your timeline are called clips, shown with their sample thumbnails or their sound waveform, that you can see better by zooming in, scrolling the bar in the top right corner of the timeline, and by enlarging tracks, dragging their upper edge. As you can see, each clip is recognized by their file names on top. In videos, the V indicates the video frames, and DA the video sound. On top you have the preview. This shows how the project is, where the red playhead on the timeline is placed. You can click on the time to place it, or you can click and drag it, in case you want to check transitions. Use space key to play and stop fast, or simply use the player at the bottom of the preview. Let's see how to edit clips. To move them through a track or another track, just click and drag. In case you move a video, you will move both video frames and sound. To unlink them, just right-click and go to Unlink Audio and Video. If you just need to put a time shift between video and audio, just move one while holding Alt down. The time next to the file name indicates precisely the time shift between the two clips. To stretch or shorten a clip, just drag its edges. Mind that you can't stretch sound and video clips over their natural extension. To cut, copy and paste, just select the clip and press Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C and Ctrl and V. To delete clips, just right-click and go to Delete. In case you mistake, press Ctrl and Z to undo your latest action. You can also use the Undo and Redo buttons in the bottom left corner. To split a clip in two, place the playhead correctly and then click on the scissor on it. Keep in mind the track's order. If you have clips overlapping on different tracks, the preview always shows the clips that lay on higher tracks. At the bottom, you have some quick buttons. Organizer opens Adobe Organizer. In Transitions, you can add transitions to your project. Choose the section on top and click on one to check how the transition is. Then click and drag one on the edges to a clip, until a rectangle symbol appears on your pointer. In this case, you will create a single side transition, used to make a clip appear or disappear. If you want to place a transition between two visible clips, called a double side transition, you need to put two clips close and drag the transition in one side, and then choose between clips. In both cases, the transition is represented through a white curved arrow on top. You can delete it, right-clicking on it and going to Delete. You can change the kind of transition, dragging there the new one you like. Also try left and right clip after adding the transition. You can change the total length of the transition, dragging its edges. Use titles and text to add text to your project. You can choose different templates in the list. Just click and drag one on the timeline. Text is simply a transparent video with text on it, so make sure to place it on a top video track. In Adjust, on the extreme right, you can personalize text as you like. In Text, you change font, size and style. In Style, you have ready-made templates. In Animation, you can add effects on your text. Just choose one and click on Apply. You can edit through the preview as well. Type inside to change text. As long as you hold Ctrl down, you can drag to move text, drag the nodes to scale, and approach them to rotate. Click on Audio to use sound templates Premiere offers you. You can use graphics to use ready image templates. Tools collects advanced tools very useful for your project. We won't see these in this beginner tutorial. Let's see the adjustments and effects. The adjustments are changes applied to a selected clip on the timeline to improve its aspect. All is listed inside Adjust. Choose one and check the preview. If you don't like the default templates, click on More below. Click on the eye to hide the adjustment applied. Adjustments can be applied on sound clips as well. Applied adjustments will be indicated by a green circle on the right. Effects are used to make the clip appearance better or more special. All is inside Effects. Just choose one and drag it on the clip interested. All effects applied on the clip are inside Applied Effects, on the extreme right. Set up the effect and check the preview. Use the eye to enable and disable the effect. Use the Reset button to come back to the default settings. Use the Bin button to remove the effect from the list. You can edit effects from the clips themselves. Next to the file name, an effect name is shown. This states which effect you are going to change if you pull up or down the envelope line on the clip. Change the effect to adjust by clicking on the effect name. You can also change effects in time very easily using the envelope line. If you hold the Ctrl down, A plus appears on your pointer when you hover the line. If you click, you will place a keyframe. If you set and drag different keyframes, you will change the envelope line, so the effect selected in time. You can personalize the envelope line or delete a point right-clicking on a keyframe. To save your project, just go to File and then to Save As. Premiere projects are saved as .prel files and can be opened to modify your project again. To export your project as a video, you must go to Publish plus Share in the top right corner and choose Social Websites, Disks, Mobile Devices, or go to Computer to render the video file itself. In this case, choose the video format on top, the destination folder using Browse, and all settings using Advanced. Then go to Save below. In case you want to render just parts of the project, simply make sure this part goes inside the work area, the lighter part shown on the timeline on top. Just drag its edges. Then, when you render, simply tick on Share Work Area only. Thanks for watching! Check out our channel for more!